me this. How did you work that one out? It's the Enigma Show. need a mind such as mine?
Patient Interview 9. Dr. Crane continues to evade questions. I believe he is quite sane. Just people. He takes no interest in the people he has hurt. His research appears to be the only motivating factor in his life. What is it about fear that drives your obsession?
Fear drives everything, Stephen. Everything. Your life is governed by fear. Every decision you
thank you.
telling you, this is my session.
It was my session, Doctor. But not anymore.
Are you okay, Doc?
I think... Yes, I...
Oh, he's fine. Just questioning his grip on reality. You should be doing the same any second.
Is that you? Wait, what are you doing?
I'd like to thank my fans for their undying support and the people of Gotham.
Can you defeat a mind such as mine?
talk about your childhood.
Miserable, Nick.
By all accounts, that is where your fascination with Riddle began. I believe discussing those years could explain your compulsive behavior.
Very well. My father hated me. Always called me a moron.
I see.
I was determined to prove him wrong, so I entered a contest at school. $20 prize for the kid who could figure out an almost impossible logic problem. I won, of course.
And that pleased your father?
Hardly. He was convinced I had cheated. He kept yelling, "You must have cheated! Admit it, you moron! You cheated!" But I swore I didn't, and he hit me for lying.
I'm sorry to hear that, Edward.
Don't be. He was right.
Curse me for a fool! How could I not see it until now? The monster had a confederate. I hid in the darkness near his cell and saw with my own eyes one of the doctors whispering to him. She looked at him through the transparent barrier with tenderness, with, dare I say, desire. My skin crawled with revulsion as she kissed the glass. Fighting the urge to dash the woman's head through the glass, I let her continue. The damnable clown might have shared secrets with her that would be useful once the mad dog has been executed. I'm sure the woman will reveal what she knows to me. If not willingly, then certainly under electronic persuasion. After that, a lobotomy, I think. Unfortunate for one so young. But her lust has put the reputation of Arkham at stake. Yes, a lobotomy. The very thing. There is no other way to ensure her silence in this regrettable matter.
Sorry about that, guys. I really hope my mic wasn't muted for the rest of the for that last episode. For this entire episode, I'd feel really bad. Oh shit! Just right, pause this really quick. I don't remember at all what I said during those episodes, and during this entirety of this episode either. I'm very sorry. I didn't realize my mic was muted for that long, you guys. I really wish I would have checked beforehand. That's why you should probably always do a test recording when you guys do YouTube, to make sure that all of your shit is actually being recorded. Oh my god, I just did it's like three episodes right there, guys, that I did with no voice. Not that you guys probably mind, you guys are probably like, sweet, he didn't talk the entire episode, that's awesome. But I'm sorry for that, you guys. I basically just talked about what we were doing for the episodes, anyway, which is majorly just doing these, obviously, as you guys probably see, talking about, you know, how it's easy to find these when you can do it, the easiest way to find these. At least you can still hear this stuff, which is good. I'm very sorry that I didn't do that, you guys. So yeah, I'm sorry for basically a majority of 19, all of 20, and all of 21 being completely silent. I'm still going to upload them like that. There's too much gone through those episodes that I'm not going to, you know, that I can't redo. So yeah, you guys get two full episodes. I'll probably actually, you know what, you guys will probably be seeing this by the time I fixed it. So yeah. Nope, my god, game. Thing is, I wouldn't have even noticed had my mom not come out here to talk to me, like, a few minutes ago. Like, I wouldn't have even noticed that my mic was muted that entire fucking time. Oh, I don't really make mistakes like that, and that's what's bugging me about this, is I made that big of a mistake. A mistake I typically don't make. We're gonna listen to this, and then we'll end the episode.
Whichever one it is, just tell me it was kind of easy to imitate and exhausting.
Hello, Miss Young. You look tired. Anything but.
I'm gonna let this go through while I record a different thing.
I'm here to help you. We all are.
Forgive my arrogance, Doctor, but if you think I need your help, well, you're in the right place.
Let's look at it a different way. Throughout your career, you have specialized in bizarre traps and convoluted clues that more often than not result in the death of the unfortunate participants.
And if the citizens of Gotham were smarter, my games would be merely an amusing diversion.
Instead of death traps.
You really should be thanking me. Weeding out the ignorant, the stupid, the useless. But don't worry. I'm sure you would survive. What a lovely photo on your desk, Doctor. Your family. Mother, perhaps.
Put that down. Get out. Guard!
Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I will see you all in the next one. Stay golden. Peace.